For those who are yet to know about it, let me tell you the story in brief. The story goes something like this. In a brief episode of Coffee with Karan, Kangna accused Karan of being a typical Bollywood biggie who is snooty and intolerant of others. Karan reacted to this in the most unprofessional way, saying that he is done with Kangna always playing the woman card or the victim card, and if she is too terrorized by the industry, she may leave. Facebook and Twitter were split down the middle, half taking Kangna's side and the other half taking Karan's. Some of them criticized Kangna's usage of the term nepotism, while others condemned Karan's usage of the term woman card. What I found interesting was that people were so outspoken about their comments and views on this nepotism and woman card, but they failed to realize the same in other places. Do you think our day-to-day life is any different?
No.
Don't you find at work one favoring another, not because he or she has done exceptionally well, but because of reasons outside your performance?
Yes.
For example, your manager offering the best and the most highly regarded projects to an employee over you, not because he or she has performed well enough to deserve them, but because of reasons otherwise. It happens every time when a manager and an employee bonds over things outside job. For example, they may have a shared history, or they may have worked together previously, or they may have bonded over things like sports. Isn't that nepotism or favoritism? Again, don't you find every other day a male friend or colleague accusing you of using the woman card to get a raise or a promotion? It's such an obvious statement from men that we achieve everything in our life just because of this woman card. Don't you feel the need to protest at those places? Don't you feel the need to protest when your friend loses out to an opportunity due to nepotism, or your colleague, pregnant colleague, is mocked off playing the woman card and is asked to stay back late at office? I don't have a problem with you posting your views and comments on Facebook or Twitter. But I do have a problem when you don't analyze the same thoughts into real life. I do have a problem when you care about Kangna and not your friend Karan. I do have a problem when you keep on citing the drawbacks of the society but don't do anything for its betterment. I do have a problem. If there needs to be a change in anything in this society right now, that is our mindset. We need to change our stereotypical mindsets and embrace the subjects about womanhood and feminism, rather than projecting them as mere objects of sexual gratification. We need to understand that they are people. They are people with layers of their own. We need to understand that we cannot undermine hard work or talent with nepotism. But mostly, we tend to forget this. We tend to tag the culprits as bullies and we ignore them. But ignoring them only reinforces a sense of power into them. They keep on bullying. It's like a permission slip that you pass on to them, and they think it is acceptable to bully one. As a result, when we ignore these issues of nepotism or accusations of misusing this woman card, the bullies continue to do the same. People often claim that the media and the entertainment industry are to be blamed for this. But I say no. The media and the society both are to be blamed for this. We have always accepted what the media has been offering till now. Had we not accepted it, had we expressed our decent for once, they would not have continued to do so. Even though we call ourselves a modern society, we are way beyond. We are way behind appreciating such practices. So today, as I stand among you all here, I would like to urge you people to take a step. Let's work towards a country that is free of misogyny, where women are respected and their freedom is appreciated. Let's work towards a country where hard work and talent is considered to be the foremost criteria to evaluate a person. I have started my work. Will you join me?